December 10th at the Gallen Center in USC, main event, Mares Cuellar on Showtime. But the co-main event, Charlo and Williams, what do you think about that fight?
I just can't wait for December 10th because that's going to be a big fight for Abner. And anything goes the way things are going in the gym, Abner's going to be my 10th world champion.
10th world champion, be up in the wall in Oxnard.
That's right, my 10th world champion. But the co-main event is also a very good fight. You know, Charlo and
Williams
are going to fight a hell of a fight. You know, those two guys are two of the best junior middleweights. And that fight's going to be, it's like a 50-50 fight. It's a pick 'em fight. I'm excited about that fight too, but you know,
we'll be in the locker room.
I'm going to be in the locker room getting Abner ready, so I won't even
get to
pay
watch
attention
it.
To that fight, but I'll definitely watch it later when I get home, you know, because I'm going to be focused on Abner, and we might have Josito on that card.
Yeah.
And maybe one other guy, I don't know, we're trying to get maybe. Oh, Speedy Mares is
Speedy Mares on the card.
Speedy Mares.
Shout out Speedy.
So,
my nigga right there.
So, you know, so we're going to be pretty busy that weekend too, you know. So, and right before Mares fight, you know, Charlo, Williams, you know,
won't be able to pay attention.
Too much attention because I'm going to be focused on preparing and getting Mares ready to get into the ring. But it is a great fight. It's a fight. It's a great card. Great opportunity for all these guys to fight on Showtime and show the boxing world what they're about. You know, because at 154,
it's kind of up for grabs right now, no?
Exactly. 154 is not really, you know.
Canelo's moving up. Moving up.
But he's moving up already. So there's no big names. There's no that one top junior middleweight that everybody's talking about. So right now is a great opportunity for these guys to show and to show that whoever wins is the best at 154.
That same day in Omaha, you got Terence Crawford and Molina. What do you think about that fight?
Terence Crawford versus Molina, is that a done deal already?
It looks like it.
Thing. You know, I'm sure I'm not the only one, but everybody's gonna think that that Crawford wins easy.
Stop it.
But Molina has fucking insane power, so
yeah, he got to punch his chest.
If he lands that one fucking punch, it could be over. Crawford's been stunned a couple times, so you know, one punch and it's over. But definitely Bob Arum, top rank, would have never put me against a fighter that's not their fighter to take a chance like that. They'll do it because, you know,
stay busy. The date was open.
HBO gave them that date, so they fucking took advantage of the date.
Yeah, and that's supposed to be Canelo.
Better than Crawford. Topper had already announced that Crawford wouldn't fight till next year.
Yeah, but then Canelo got hurt.
Exactly. Then Canelo and then Triple G's fight didn't happen. So HBO still has that date. So what they say, fuck it, let's jump in it. Top rank, let's bring Crawford. So that's smart. And they picked an opponent that has a name, had a great win in his last fight, but shouldn't beat Crawford. But like I said, Molina, fucker, you know, he has that power.
So that day you got HBO versus Showtime. If you look back this year, who's had the better year of the two, HBO or Showtime? Closing out the year, like
both, you know, they're both coming strong. You know, Showtime didn't have much the first half of the year, and HBO has had fights all year long, but Showtime with those new fights that they announced just recently, they have quite a few fights that are very, very interesting, and that is hard to beat. But you know, HBO has Kovalev Ward, that can't beat that. Has Walters Lomachenko, you know, those are fucking badass fights. But then Showtime had
Santa Cruz Frampton, had Mikey Thurman back, Porter.
Thurman Porter, you know, they're both doing a great job with the type of fighters. But that's what's hurting boxing. That's what's hurting, you know, there's two or three
that
different
split.
And it's, they split up, and that, you know, so half could see HBO and half goes to see Showtime, and have people go there, have people go there to see it live. So that's what's hurting boxing. That's why UFC has only one, and nobody could watch anything else because there's nothing else on TV when they have a big show, and there's no other promoter doing that show that same day. So that's why all the attention is at that one night. That's why UFC is doing so good, because they only have one. And you know, it's sad that boxing is not like that. It's not like that. It used to be, but not anymore. But what can we do? Fighters are, you know, we still gotta continue working. That's our job. That's our work. So we have to support Showtime. We have to support HBO. We have to support all the promoters in the world, because we work with all the promoters in the world. We work with all the TV networks in the world. So we gotta suck it up.
Pretty much. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. EsNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.